Well, Nicholas Goymanitz was a tough kid from KCK. He went to Wyandotte High School, enlisted in the Marines, and then went overseas in World War II. After a battle in Japan in July of 1943, Goymanitz's family never heard from him or of him again.
They always thought, oh, one day he'll come home.
Come home to this house at 603 Thompson Street in KCK. It was where Nicholas Goymanitz, his brother and four sisters, grew up in the Croatian neighborhood of Strawberry Hill.
I never knew him. However, he was always very much a part of the family.
Her uncle killed the year after Teresa Moeller was born, but every family gathering, every holiday, Uncle Nicholas was there in stories and in spirit.
There was never closure. You know, never. There was never any closure on it. They always thought that he would come back.
Private First Class Goymanitz was assigned to the 4th Raider Battalion. On July 20th, 1943, the 4th Raiders assaulted a Japanese stronghold at Bairoko Harbor, New Georgia Island, in the Solomon Islands. According to U.S. Marine records, during the Battle of New Georgia, Goymanitz was last seen after crawling through heavy fire and providing medical care to a Marine, while he was also mortally wounded.
That doesn't surprise me. And I think he has a medal for that, too.
The remains of 21 unidentified Marines were eventually recovered from that battlefield and buried in Hawaii in 1949, including one then named X-6.
My mother thought that he had been, this is how my mother thought, that he had been hurt so bad that he didn't want to come back. He was embarrassed to come back. So she never thought that he had died, actually.
In 2018, after Goymanitz's parents, brother, and sisters had died, a knock on Moeller's door by two Marines brought the closure her family had been looking for. The body known by the Marine Corps as X-6 for 75 years is her uncle, Private First Class Nicholas Goymanitz.
Family. Family roots. Mm-hmm. What it means. What it would have meant for them. You know, I can just feel it.
It's the end of a long road that not only brings Moeller closure for her family, but also comfort and hope during what she calls a divisive time in our country.
These Marines have taken care of bringing back one of their own. You know, they always say that about the Marines, but this really shows it. And my feeling for my country was, it really helped my feeling, because I've been depressed a lot of the time because of what's going on now.
The body of Private First Class Nicholas Goymanitz will be brought back to Kansas City at the end of April. Uncle Nicholas will be met at the airport by his surviving family members, nieces and nephews, great nieces and nephews, and then they will accompany his body to Leavenworth National Cemetery, where he will be properly buried with full military honors. Shannon O'Brien, Fox 4 News.